most of us were required to do it as students, study a foreign language. It can be an enriching experience for folks who are looking to maybe broaden their skills as a professional or connect with other cultures. But if someone struggles with a learning challenge like dyslexia, their own language is tough. Learning a second language, of course, can be even tougher. But there is a strategy for that at Chesapeake Bay Academy. Jared Settner joins us once again to talk about the things that CBA can do and maybe some tips for parents who have a child who seems to be struggling with reading or that they suspect may have dyslexia. Thanks for coming back to the Hampton Roadshow.
Thank you so much.
Many folks might say a child with dyslexia probably can't learn a foreign language. Is that true?
No, that's not true. Dyslexic students have a difficult time learning a foreign language basically because of their lack of phonemic awareness. Mm-hmm. Phonemic awareness is, you can think of it as the building blocks of language, how sound comes together to form words. And dyslexics usually are not so good at that, which is why if you've met a dyslexic person, chances are they're not the best speller in the world, because that's where that whole phonemic awareness comes into play. Mm-hmm. So it's more difficult for dyslexics to learn a foreign language, but it's certainly not impossible.
Mm-hmm. And you know, one of the things that we covered already was that their own language, their natural language, can be a challenge. But when I was learning Spanish, you kind of learn how complicated and difficult English is.
Right.
You know, in terms of some of the words that we have and the grammatic rules that we have. Do you ever find that because some of the other languages are a little more straightforward in their rules and sentence structure, that it's not as bad as students think?
Right. Well, people with dyslexia, there are different degrees of it. So what works for one might not work for another. So there are some dyslexic students who do have a problem with English and learning the rules of it. And then when they do Spanish or German, they have a much easier time with it because the rules are more straightforward.
And consistent.
And consistent, which we don't have in English.
Right.
So many dyslexic students like that, and they succeed in that foreign language. What's also important is just the foreign language itself, because of the auditory processing of dyslexic students, meaning how they hear sound as well. So how the language sounds is also important. There are some students that just take better to Spanish or to German because of the sound, as where French is a little bit more difficult for dyslexic students because it sounds so different from English. Mm-hmm. So really, like many things with dyslexia, it's really on an individual basis, and you really kind of have to shop around because languages are different, and what might work for one might not work for another.
All right, so maybe not set yourself up for to learn a language.
Right.
Maybe we have a great chance of success.
Right.
But of course, never say it's impossible.
Never say it's impossible. And something else that people can think about, especially on a college level, is reading a language rather than speaking it. For example, many colleges have language requirements, but many of those requirements are just a reading proficiency. So for the dyslexic student who can memorize words as code, for example, they can read a language much easier than they can speak it. Mm-hmm. So reading a language and having that count as your foreign language requirement is definitely a possibility, and it's something to look into.
And probably models a lot of what happens in business. A lot of folks are motivated to learn a second language for business purposes or professional purposes. And let's face it, a lot of communication in business now is email and
texting. Exactly.
Gotcha.
Right.
Okay. If someone at home has a child that they suspect has dyslexia, where can they go to get to find out for sure? Or are there any hallmark signs that you would say this is dyslexia? You know, the fact that your child may write their S's backwards is not, don't automatically assume it's dyslexia.
Right. Dyslexia comes in so many forms and shapes that it's impossible to say, like, by writing your S's backwards, then, you know, you are dyslexic. But I think parents should definitely go with their gut, the earlier the better, and have your child tested. Talk to your public school system, talk to those people and get that process going, because the earlier that they can be diagnosed, the more that can be done to help them as they learn those crucial skills of reading, writing, spelling, and things like that.
And of course, the reason that we bring Jared in from Chesapeake Bay Academy is because Chesapeake Bay Academy is a school for children. Every child there has some kind of different learning style or a challenge that needs to be overcome. They have also assessment services, but the public school system, oftentimes they do this at low or no cost to kind of get the ball rolling if your child is really young, between, you know, up to 3 years old.
Mm-hmm.
Infant-toddler connections through your community services
right.
board also have some assessment abilities, too, if you're worried about expense. Okay, if you want to learn more about dyslexia, though, the neuropsychology of dyslexia, this is an event hosted by Chesapeake Bay Academy, November 1st at 7 o'clock at the Virginia Beach Central Library. Here's another opportunity for you to learn more, www.cba-va.org. This is a free seminar for you as well. Thanks so much.
Thank you so much for having me.
Today.
Thank you.